MedCram.com.
Okay, well, welcome to another MedCram.com board vitals question. This one comes from our Naplex bank, which is targeted to pharmacists. And the question goes like this: how many mLs of a 1:4 solution of drug X is required to produce 4 liters of a 1:20 solution? And that W/V there is stating that it's a weight divided by volume solution. And they want the answer in numeric value only, rounded to the nearest whole number. Okay, so there's a lot of things to unpack here. Let's talk about this. One of the things that we've got to tackle here is this thing about ratio versus proportion. And I don't want it to trip you up here, because this is not going to go along with pure mathematics. In a pure mathematical situation, a 1:4 ratio would indicate that in the whole, that there is one part that is mixed with 4 parts. And so therefore, the actual part that we're looking at would not be 25%, but actually 20% of the whole. That's if we were doing things perfectly mathematically, but that is actually not the case. We know that a 1 divided by 4 is something that we can all understand, because 1 divided by 4 is 0.25. And we can all understand that, right? We have a quarter of it. We have one part taken up in the 4. So what is that going on here is that we've got a solute being dissolved in a solution. And because of that, what science does, at least when it comes to a pharmacology, is it likes to use this terminology of a 1:4 solution to actually refer to this. So don't get tripped up with this colon here. When they say 1:4 solution, they put a colon in there, a 1:4, they're actually referring to 1 part by weight in 4 parts. This is actually not 20% like we would do it in pure mathematics. It's actually a 25% solution. Okay? So another example would be a 1:20, okay? I'm not gonna go 1 divided by 21 to figure what that is. It's actually 1 divided by 20, which is gonna be 5%. Okay? So that's the first thing that you wanna make sure that you don't get tripped up on. So let's revisit this question again. How many mLs of a solution, specific solution, a 1:4, that would be a 25% solution, of drug X is required, in other words, is needed at the beginning, to be diluted out to produce 4 liters of a solution which is more dilute? So in other words, we're going from a 25% solution down to a 5% solution, weight divided by volume. And so the question is how many mLs are we going to need to make that happen? And of course, what you're doing here is you're simply adding water to the solution to take a known amount of solute, of particles, and simply have them at a less concentration. And so what's not changing here, and this is the key here, what's not changing is the actual solute. I can add water to something all day, but it's not going to change the number of molecules of solute. So because of that, we can actually create an equivalent expression. And let's show you that. So this is the expression that rules all of this, and that's C1V1 equals C2V2. Now, why does this work? Concentration, remember, the units of concentration is going to be something like milligrams per liter. And if I'm going to be multiplying that by a volume, which is a liter, what's going to be left is I'm going to be left with milligrams. And if we're dealing with the same substance, milligrams can be moles, right? If you know the formula mass or the atomic mass, depending on what you're dealing with. And so what you have here is the certain amount of milligrams of solute is going to be equal to the same milligrams of solute on this side, because over here we have milligrams per liter times liters. And so what can happen is that the actual concentrations can change and the solutions that they are in, but what will never change in this situation is the amount of solute. So let's take a look at this. Obviously, if we have something with a high concentration in a low volume, we can add volume to that, and what will happen is the concentration will go down. And that's precisely what we have in the situation here. Let's read the question again. How many mLs? So the question here is looking for how much volume. So we're looking for a V here. How much volume of a 1 to 4 solution, that's a 25% solution, of drug X is required to produce 4 liters of a 1 to 20 weight by volume solution? So what you've got to do is you've got to look here is required to produce. What they're going to do is they're simply going to add water to the volume that you already started off with to make this 1 in 20 solution. So let's go ahead and write down what this looks like. So we're starting out with a 1 to 4 solution. So remember, 1 to 4, we said, can be written just like 1 divided by 4. And that's the C coming down here. The V is what we're looking for. We're looking for how much volume is going to be necessary. And we'll put that right here and continue that as the variable. Now, what's staying the same here is the solute. What's going to change is the concentration and the volume. So what's the new concentration? The new concentration that they're looking for is a 1 to 20 solution. But as we've already said, that can be written as 1 divided by 20. And the new volume that we're looking for is, if we're going to put it in terms of milliliters, is 4,000. Okay, there's 4,000 milliliters in 4 liters. So if we do the math, what we get here is this is equal to 200, and this over here on this side is V1 over 4. If we multiply both sides by 4, we get the final answer, which is V1 is equal to 800 mLs. So if we plug that back in here, we'll see now the final equation will say, if I take 800 mLs of a 1 to 4 solution, I can simply add enough water until I reach 4,000 mLs. In other words, I will be adding 3,200 mLs. And when I reach that point of 4,000, my new concentration will be 1 to 20. So once again, and the answer is 800 mLs. Well, thanks for joining us.